Yes, students, so now we will be discussing about multiple disabilities. So what do you mean by multiple disabilities? So it means a person with several disabilities, such as sensory disability associated with a motor disability. Depending upon the deficiency, a severe intellectual disability may be included the term multiple. Individually usually has more than one significant disability, such as movement difficulties, sensory loss, and or behavior or emotional disorder. Now coming to the assessment of learners with multiple disabilities. Determination of eligibility based on the definition and standards for two or more disabilities. The nature of the combination of the learner's disabilities require significant developmental and educational programming that cannot be accommodated with special education program by addressing any one of the identified disabilities. Documentation including observation and or assessment of how multiple disabilities adversely impact the child's educational performance in his or her environment. Coming to the effective educational program, independence is the goal. No matter how small or big task is, the child should learn to use it to make life easy and simpler for him or her. Teaching skills that are functional and meaningful with the limited opportunities available to the child. Teaching skills in natural settings. The child is able to remember things that he or she learns while going through his or her day-to-day routines. Providing assistance as needed. Encourage the child in every attempt. Providing repeated opportunities to practice. This will help the child to get opportunities to try out the activity again and again. Using real concrete objects. When experience to know about the world is so limited, it is better to use objects that he sees and uses every day rather than expensive and unusual things. Developing routines, activity schedule. Having a fixed timetable for the day with the child. This helps him to have more control over his or her life and to anticipate what is going to happen with him next. This also helps to encourage communication attempts by the child immensely. Multisensory approach. It is best to make use of all remaining sensory abilities of the child, like seeing, hearing, touching, smelling, and movements. Planning inclusive activities. With highly individualized activities being planned for the child, there is always a risk that either the parent or one caregiver is constantly trying to teach the child. Making use of resource person from the community. It is important that the best advantage is taken from the resource persons from the community as teachers. Coming to the accommodations or supports, a multidisciplinary team consisting of the learner's parents, education specialist, and medical specialist in the areas in which the individual demonstrates problems should work together to plan and coordinate necessary services. Involvement of the appropriate professionals. It will be a multidisciplinary team which includes various professionals, starting from the physicians and various physiotherapists, occupational therapists, etc. Accessibility of school building and classroom. Having a buddy system that ensures their needs are heard and that they get aid when needed. simple, specific, and systematic instructions should be given so that they can easily understand and can perform with the instructions. Using appropriate aids when communicating with the child, and engage the child regularly in oral language activities. So in the last, for summing up of this particular unit, and we have to remember as teachers that an inclusive classroom is one in which all the students are welcomed and differing learning needs are supported in a meaningful and responsive learning environment. A key aspect of moving beyond enrollment to ensuring full participation of children with special needs is by positively affecting teachers' beliefs towards students with disabilities. It is very important for teachers to try out different strategies to find those what work best for them and for the child in his or her classroom. That's all in this video. Thank you very much.